everyone, I'm Harry, welcome to my channel, and today we're going to do another How to Sound Like video. This time we're going to try and get the times on Find Me by Kings of Leon. I should say I didn't manage to find a full multi-track for this, so I had to program the drums, the synth part, and record the bass in myself, so it's going to be pretty close, but obviously not as close as if we use the original multi-track, but I think it'll be close enough to hear the guitar parts anyway. So before we get started, if you like this Sound Like video at any point, please leave a like, comment and subscribe, and hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot, and that way I won't miss out on any of my future uploads. There's going to be affiliate links down in the description to every piece of gear I use in this video and to record my videos. These do help support the channel out further, so I'd really appreciate it if you go and check them out. So Find Me is a song from one of Kings of Leon's most recent albums, and probably one of my favorite albums by them. And the reason I picked this is because I really needed a really good overdrive that was really low to medium gain, but also had a lot of clarity for the little arpeggio parts that Matthew plays. And then of course, getting a nice clean slash very edge of breakup tone for Caleb's parts on the 335. So I recently got sent the Foxcatcher by Copper Sound Pedals, which is definitely one of the best low to medium gain overdrive pedals I played, and it has tons of clarities, so you can play all those arpeggios and you're actually hearing all the notes rather than them just all melt together. It's a really killer pedal, kind of a take on a Blues Breaker, and it also has a boost in there. If you'd like to see my full demo of the Foxcatcher by Copper Sound Pedals, there'll be a link up in the cards, in the description, and pinned in the comments. So effects wise it's a pretty simple song. It's just getting that overdrive right, so there's loads of clarity and a little bit of grit for both parts. The amp I'm using today is my Hampstead Artist 60 Plus RT, which is one of my favorite clean pedal platform amps. A little bit of reverb's coming from that as well. Then that's running into the Tone King Iron Man 2 Attenuator just to knock off a few dBs, then into a Celestion G12M65 Creamback speaker and being recorded by a Lewitt MTP440 dynamic microphone, which is like an SM57 with a tiny bit more bass. So we'll take a look at Caleb's parts first. So of course we see him using his 335. Now I don't have a 335 with mini humbuckers, but my 1959 reissue ES335 with Monty's low output PAF humbucking pickups do the job just fine. Again, we're using the Foxcatcher for our little bit of drive, and it's a really subtle drive for this part, but it definitely adds to the character, and it's kind of like an EQ shift as well. So if I show you what the 335 sounds like going straight into the amp, then I'll kick on the Foxcatcher with the settings that I use so you can see and hear exactly what's going on and what it's actually doing to our bass clean tone. So the 335 straight into the amp sounds like this. So there you go, you can see what the Foxcatcher is doing to our bass clean tone. It's just giving us a little bit of drive and kind of shifting the EQ a little bit. So now I'll pull Caleb's parts that I played on the 335 from the intro song Isolated, so you can see and hear exactly what's going on, and you'll see the settings of the Foxcatcher by Copper Sound Pedals on screen as well. We'll be right back. Okay, so now we'll take a look at Matthew's parts. So I've seen him play this live on what looks like a Telecaster style guitar, because it has the Telecaster style pickups, but it's a different shape. I think it might be a Fanoi guitar, but I decided to use my Matmul T Classic, which is a great vintage style Telecaster. Again, we were using the Foxcatcher Bicop sound pedals to give us that nice little grit with loads of clarity. And I just pulled the drive up on the pedal a little bit compared to Caleb's rhythm part. So throughout the whole song, it's just that going straight into the amp with a little bit of spring reverb. And then when it gets to the solo, there's like this delay that's dead in time with the song. So for that, I decided to use the Source Audio Collider, which is a great multi-delay and reverb pedal. And I was just in the tape delay algorithm with settings like this. The only thing to note, on the last little two notes of the song, it kind of goes into self-oscillation. So I play those and then just quickly pull up the feedback control with my foot. So if I show you what the Matmul T Classic sounds like going straight into the amp, and then I'll kick on the Foxcatcher Bicop sound pedal so you can hear what the overdrive pedal is doing to our bass tone. So the Matmul T Classic straight into the amp sounds like this. And then that's the tone that we use throughout all of it. And then, of course, for the solo, I just kick on the delay. But we won't look at that because you'll hear it from the intro song anyway. So if I pull out Matthew's track isolated from the intro song, again, you'll see the settings of the Foxcatcher on screen throughout. And then when it gets to the solo, just bear in mind, we kicked on the collider in the tape delay algorithm with settings like this. And on the last two notes, I was just pulling up the feedback control to make it go into self-oscillation. So Matthew's parts isolated from the intro song sound like this. So there we have it. That was a look at how to sound like Find Me by Kings of Leon. Definitely one of my favourite songs from their most recent albums. And having that great low to medium gain overdrive from the Foxcatcher that has tons of clarity really helped me get close on this. It's really important when you're playing those kind of arpeggio things on the Telecaster that if you don't have an overdrive pedal that has a lot of clarity, it's all just going to kind of mush together and you're not going to hear the individual notes properly. Like I said, the Foxcatcher is definitely one of my favourite low to medium gain overdrives, and I thought it really did the job and got us close. Again, if you want to see my full demo of the Foxcatcher, there'll be a link up in the cards, in the description, and pinned in the comments. And then, of course, having the Source Audio Collider in the tape delay to give us that nice quarter note delay for the solo, and of course, bringing up the feedback control to give us that self-oscillation that we hear towards the end of the solo really came in handy. Let me know down in the comments how close you thought I got to the original song and any future had soundlight videos you'd like to see me do. If you did like this soundlight video, please leave a like, comment and subscribe, and hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot, and that way you won't miss out on any of my future uploads. Other than that, go onto my channel, check out some of my playlists. I have plenty more lessons, covers, gear demos, had soundlight videos, and anything guitar related. As always, I've been Harry, and thanks for watching.